Hello students, in today's video we are going to see what is called as union of two sets. So to understand the concept very properly students, I'll be explaining you the union of two sets with the help of three examples, and at the end of the video we are going to compare all the three examples side by side for the better understanding of the concept. Okay, so let's see the first example. So I have taken two sets, set A and set B. So the elements of set A are 2, 5, 8, 9 and 12. And elements of set B are 4, 6, 8, 9, 13 and 15. Now what do you mean by union of two sets? Now union means what? We have to write down a set which includes all the elements of A as well as all the elements of B. But before that, let's see the elements 8 and 9. So if you see the two sets very carefully, okay, the number 8 and 9 is repeated in set A as well as in set B. So when I write down the union of two sets, means when I write down all the elements from A and B, I write the element 8 and 9, that is the number 8 and 9, only once. Why? Because in a set, whenever you write in a listing method, the repetition of elements is not allowed. So 8 and 9 has to be written only once, which are common elements. Now let's see how do we draw the Venn diagram of A union B. Okay, now if you see A union B, there are certain elements which are common from A as well as B, that is elements 8 and 9. So when I draw the Venn diagram, I will draw two circles, or it could be any other figure, intersecting each other. Why intersecting, students? Because at the point of intersection, we are going to write down the common elements. Okay, so let me give the name of the two sets, A and B. So the part where the two circles are intersecting, so that part will be filled by the two elements 8 and 9. So 8 and 9 is nothing but the common part of A also as well as B also. Means these are common elements of A and B. Now what I'll do, I will write down the remaining elements of A, that is 2, 5 and 12, and the remaining elements of B, that is 4, 6, 13 and 15. So this is how you fill a diagram. Now students, the diagram is yet incomplete. We are finding A union B, means we have to shade the Venn diagram. So what do you have to shade? We have to shade the union. Union means what? Everything. So this is what we have to shade, and this is the Venn diagram for A union B. Okay, so let us take second example. Okay, again I'm taking two sets, A and B. So in set A we have 2, 5, 8, 9 and 12, and in set B have numbers 4, 6, 10, 11, 13 and 15. So if you see the two sets very carefully, students, in these two sets there is no element common. We don't have any common numbers. Okay, so when I write down A union B, obviously I'm going to write down all elements from A and all elements of B, and since there is no repetition of elements, okay, we have to write down all elements. Now there is a small difference when we draw the Venn diagram for this. Now since there are no common elements from A and B, how do we draw the Venn diagram? Let's see. So I'm going to draw two circles which are touching each other. If you remember, students, for example 1, we did two circles intersecting each other. Here we have to draw two circles touching each other, and I'm giving the name A and B. Okay, now since there are no common elements, what I'll do, I will write down all the elements from set A and all the elements from set B. Okay, and make sure that the two circles are touching each other, not intersecting. And since we are doing union, so I have to shade everything. So yes, this is the Venn diagram, the final Venn diagram for A union B. Okay, now let's see the third example and the last example. Okay, so I'm giving again set A and set B. Set A has 6, 11 and 13, and set B has 4, 6, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 15. Now if you see the two sets very carefully, what we see is the numbers 6, 11 and 13 are repeated. Now if you see set A very carefully, students, you will see that all elements of set A are present in set B. Okay, I'll repeat again, all elements of set A are present in set B. So we all know, how do we write down union? So when I write A union B, I'm going to write down all elements, but I will make sure that I don't repeat 6, 11 and 13. I'm writing 6, 11 and 13 only once. Okay, now understand how do we draw the Venn diagram for this. Okay, this example is very important. Now if you see the example, I see that set A is inside set B. Okay, means all elements of set A is inside B. Okay, so now see how I'm drawing the Venn diagram. So I'm drawing two figures, okay, inside each other. Yes, okay. The outer one I'll name it as B and the inner one I'm going to name it as A. Why? Because I can say that set A is inside set B. So inside A means what I'm going to write down? I'm going to write down 6, 11, 13. So 6, 11, 13 are the elements of set A, which is also a part of set B. So what I'll write down outside? I will write down the remaining numbers, that is 4, 10, 12 and 15. And since we are finding union of two sets, I'm going to shade everything. Okay, students. So we did three examples. Now let us summarize everything. Okay. So when we did the ray diagrams, we did three type of Venn diagrams. So the first type was what? When there are two sets having some elements common. So how we did the diagram? We did two intersecting circles, and where the two circles were intersecting, we wrote the common elements. The type 2 was two sets having nothing common. So what we did? We did two touching circles. Okay. Since they were touching, they were not intersecting. So there is nothing common from A and B. Now type C, what we did was set A means elements of set A are present in B. So set A will come inside and set B will come outside. So these are the three types of Venn diagrams for the union of two sets. I hope you understood this very properly, students. Thank you so much.